Good morning. I'll be showing you the easy way to show you the rule of three. And we'll be I'm sorry. We'll be working in Maria Tørrelles book. Botanicum. And I'm sorry about my cat is rubbing me. So the rule of three is really that you always color Eros. Slut med det. That you always color with three shades of the same color or three color that goes together. For example, you can use three shades of one color, which I will do on one of these leaves. And I'll show you just I'll try to zoom in again. I gotta come some. There, thank you. And I have a dark shade and a medium. Oh, you two can see that there. A medium. One dark, one medium, and one light green. And you can use this technique on everything, really, from leaves, flowers, fabrics, like anything, really. By choosing three shades of one color, you already then have the shade color and the highlight color. And I'm again coloring in circular movements. Just going the whole way around this area. Changing to my middle color. Going around and a little bit over where I put down my darkest color. Now you see that I'm also shaping my leaf with the highlight or the highlight color. Now I think I'll take the dark again and make the edges even darker. So they actually show a little bit better. Going around all of this leaf. And again with my middle color, and again making it a little bit more vibrant and adding another layer of this. Now I can push this one a little bit out because it got a little too dark at that line. And I don't really want lines in my leaves. Then I take my lightest shade and just go in and fill the white space with it. And taking it a little bit over everything else. Just so it looks more, what's it called, cohesive. That it actually goes together. Now you can also use this rule with different colors that goes together. Like if I take this blue, this is Copenhagen Blue. PC, let me see now, 06. Let me see if I can find it on my color chart. Yes, Copenhagen Blue is 906. I can like put it in the bottom of this sleeve. Then I can take my green and just go over that, because green is made out of blue and yellow, so I can use green with this blue and time. And I can even choose a yellow now in the bottom. Let's see which yellow. Maybe this one. This is, what's it called? Deco yellow. You see 1011. So. Then I also take that over the blue parts. It will make it a little bit like a dark green, but you still see the blue in it. So you see that you can actually use different colors too. Or like if I want to color one of these flowers here, I can use three shades of, let's say, pink. Like this is my Black Cherry PC 10078. I can pull out my Mulberry, which is PC 995. And then I still have my Deco Pink PC 1014. I just put the darkest one where the shadow areas should be. I want a little bit down there, a little bit around here. Going in with my middle. So this is a little too short. I just have to sharpen it. Here I can go in with my medium color. Ja da. So my cats, I have three cats. They are all Bengal cats, and they talk a lot, and they tell me everything I do wrong. They tell me when they want food, when they want the right kind of food, when they want water. Yes, and they love water. They actually can roll around in the shower when we have showered, And they are very, very talkative. Then I come in with my lightest pink and just color over it all, making a little highlighted area. Now if I feel that my highlight isn't light enough, I can just take a white gel pen or a white Posca or something like that and go in and make it even lighter. So, three shades of pink, three shades of green, three colors that goes to together that are color tones, as I call them, and they are colors that are next to each other on a color. I'm sorry, like that, in a color wheel. So that was the rule of three. I hope that helped a little bit, and I'll see you next time. Take care. Bye.